Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today let me show you how to make captioned meme photos like this one in the Photos app. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a community of supporters. Join us and get exclusive content at MacMost.com/Patreon. So usually graphics like these with text over an image are created either in an app like Photoshop or maybe using some sort of online website that puts text on an image. But you don't need any of that. Now I'm using Photos version 4, which is part of macOS Mojave. And using that, I can go into Edit. And you won't see any ability to add text or captions or anything in here. You'll just see light and color adjustments. You'll see the ability to do filters and crop and all of that. But if you click on the Extensions button here, one of the extensions you'll have is Markup. The rest of these are added by third-party apps, but Markup comes with the operating system. And you get a set of tools here that's similar to the set of tools you might be familiar with in Preview and in Mail for marking up an image or a PDF. Now I can create a text box by clicking on the Text button here. Then I can type my text. Once I've entered my text, I can select all with Command A, and I can make adjustments here in the text properties. So I'm going to change the font here to something else. And I can adjust the size a bit. I can even make it bold. And now I can move this text around and put it where I want. Now often it's useful to create more of a contrast between the text and the background. And you can do that by adjusting the photo before you add this text here. But you could also add a box. I'm going to click here and add a box and then position that. Now it's important to set the border to nothing. And then I'm going to set the color to black. And then I'm going to go to Show Colors here and I'm going to adjust the opacity and make it semi-transparent. So maybe for something like this, about 30%. And I could take this and position it over the entire photo. Now it's going to cover the text as well. So what I want to do is I want to select the text. I'm going to cut it with Command X, paste it again. So now it's on top. So now the cover here goes between the text and the image. And I can have it fill the entire image there, or maybe I just want it to fill the bottom so the text just stands out but the rest of the image isn't dimmed. And when you're done, hit Save Changes and it will save this now, and that's what the image will look like. All editing photos is non-destructive, meaning I can always use this Revert to Original button when I'm in editing mode. So I can even say I'm done but go back into editing mode and revert to original. Now once you're done with it, this is what the image will look like. So anytime you export or share, it's going to have this text on it. Here's another image. Now I want to go and edit it and crop it before I add the meme text to it. So I'm going to crop it like this and hit done. And then I can go and edit, markup, and add text now here. Then maybe change the font here to something else. Maybe right justify it. Make it larger. And then I'm going to move it here to the corner. And this works pretty well with the color as it is. It stands out really well. So here's one of the most classic memes here. And let's say you want to actually have text in a box here, because that's what's usually done with this classic image. So you can edit and do markup. Instead of using the text button here, you can actually go and use a box. And boxes can have text in them. So I can do, I'll adjust the size down and center it. And I can adjust the text box there. I can make it something where it's not semi-transparent. So like that. And I can position this here. And then I could option drag. Anytime you need to duplicate something, you can option drag it. And add similar text there. There's also a lot of other things you could do. For instance, you've got a bubble box there that you could use. And you could type text in here. You've got other shapes as well. You could also add lines and arrows. And of course, you can use one of these two tools here to just draw a line on it, and you can set whether or not it follows what you drew or tries to smooth it out. Now if you have an image that's not in the Photos app, just a file, you can open it up in Preview and then use the markup tools in there. And it's essentially the same thing here. So you could add text, you could add a box and type text into the box. You can change colors and add lines and everything that you could do in Photos just in Preview. And then when you're done, you could go and export it as an image, and the text and elements you've added will be embedded in the new image file. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.